Hi there, my name is Chris Wilterdink, and I'm the Director of Young People's Ministries at Discipleship Ministries of the United Methodist Church. I am so excited to worship with you today as part of the Upper Room's regular times for worship and prayer. Today, you will hear the voices and songs of young people from all over the world, young people who are members of United Methodist Churches, seeking to discover more about themselves and more about God through how they live their lives and how they work with each other. In the middle of August, for young people, it is the season of thinking about getting back to school if they are still a student. It's also a very special year because the Summer Olympics are taking place, and we're watching the world try to come together in what has been a fractured and split world, finding ourselves separated from each other due to travel restrictions and pandemic-related responses. I hope that this time of worship and prayer enlivens you, reminds you of what it was like to be young, and reignites your call to love one another because God first loved us. Amen.
Romans chapter 12, verses 6 through 16. In His grace, God has given us different gifts for doing certain things well. So, if God has given you the ability to prophesy, speak out with as much faith as God has given you. If your gift is serving others, serve them well. If you are a teacher, teach well. If your gift is to encourage others, be encouraging. If it is giving, give generously. If God has given you leadership ability, take the responsibility seriously. And if you have a gift for showing kindness to others, do it gladly. Don't just pretend to love others, really love them. Hate what is wrong, hold tightly to what is good. Love each other with genuine affection, and take delight in honoring each other. Never be lazy, but work hard and serve the Lord enthusiastically. Rejoice in our confident hope, be patient in trouble, and keep on praying. When God's people are in need, be ready to help them. Always be eager to practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Don't curse them. Pray that God will bless them. Be happy with those who are happy, and weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with each other. Don't be too proud to enjoy the company of ordinary people, and don't think you know it all. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Знали ми, хто ти є для нас. Hello, Upper Room family. My name is Maggie Taylor, and I am the co-chair of the Division on Ministries with Young People. Today, I'm so excited to see our service full of young people from around the world sharing in their love of God and their gifts and talents. Today, our scripture reading comes from Romans when Paul is talking to the Romans about their gifts, their talents, the way that God has blessed them. He tells them to use their gifts, their talents, and blessings to their advantage in praising God, but also to be humble and kind, to love one another, and to make sure that they are humble and that they still associate with ordinary people. Today, I want to talk a little bit about how Paul speaks to us today. I want to talk about an Olympics of faith. Many of us have been watching the Olympics lately and maybe have thought, oh my gosh, I could never do that, which very possibly might be true. We might not be able to run a mile that fast or even 400 meters. We might not be able to swim or pole vault or lift what some of these athletes are lifting during the Olympics. But that doesn't mean that we don't have strength beyond normal means. We all have faith. And yes, unlike the Olympics, we don't have a set for your schedule of usage of our faith, but we do have special strengths and talents with our faith. I want you to think about your strengths and talents today as we pray together. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for the gifts and talents that you've given us. Be with us this day as we explore those and how to use those to the glory of your kingdom. In your name we pray. Amen. What is your favorite Olympic event? Is it something that you think you could never do? Or maybe is it something that you think if you worked hard enough, you could become better at? One of my favorite Olympic events is weightlifting. I do CrossFit and I think, wow, I could never lift the way that they are lifting. For me, it's something that I can relate to. I know what 55 kilograms is and I know how much 126 kilograms is and how much of a lift and a success that would be. Paul knew the faith of the people in Rome. He knew that they would be challenged by the outside circumstances, that they would be challenged by each other since they had different gifts. Faith is similar to the Olympics. The gifts of the Spirit are like the Olympic sports. But just because you have one gift of the Spirit or you're good at one Olympic sport doesn't mean you don't practice the others, right? Runners lift weights, weightlifters swim, swimmers run. So if you are blessed with the gift of leadership, that doesn't mean you don't pray. If you're blessed with the gift of hospitality, it doesn't mean that you don't lead in some way. We're all blessed with different gifts, but the key is making sure that we hone our gifts to the best use of God's kingdom. As we present our gifts to the world, we show the glory of God to others. If you've been watching the Olympics, you've seen many things. You've seen triumphs. You've seen the Philippines take home a gold medal in weightlifting. You've seen Italy and Qatar share a gold medal in pole vaulting. And you've seen an American gymnast say, "I need to take time to heal," but still cheer on her team. Throughout watching the Olympics, we can learn so much about ourselves as a faith community. We aren't isolated in our gifts. We must use them together holistically to bring forth the kingdom of God. No one gift is more important than another. And we are joined together by a common goal and a common purpose. In the Olympics, it is to compete, to win. But it's also a love of the sport. And when we show our gifts through prayer, through service, through leadership, yes, as individuals, oftentimes we do shine. But that's not the purpose. The purpose is a common love of God and an understanding of God's grace that covers so many of us. Training is what we're in the midst of at the moment. No, we don't have a four-year schedule knowing I'm going to be called up to serve God on this date in 4 years. Olympians have that luxury, but we all know they compete in many other competitions, nationals, finals, Olympic trials, leading up to that and intermittently through that. Our faith is the same way. No, we don't have a time every 4 years where we have to show our gifts and talents. But we're constantly honing them, bringing life to them in the way that God called us to, so that at the time in which we see a brother and sister in need, or we see a need for leadership, or we see a need for prayer, we can step up and we can do that. Let us remember that our gifts are not for ourselves, and that we should use our gifts with humility, never looking at someone with a different gift, or maybe even a gift we can't perceive as less than us. Paul talks about ordinary people or people who aren't of faith, making sure that we are in community with them and we spend time with them. Because what good is our faith if we keep it to ourselves? And what good is our love if we only give it to ourselves? Last but not least, Paul reminds the Romans to love their enemies, love their competitors, love those who challenge them, love those who hurt them, and help them to strive for good. Hope for the best for them. That's one of the most difficult things that I face in this passage personally. I can get on board with honing my skills, celebrating others, but loving my enemies, especially those who have hurt people close to me, loving my enemies is hard. Loving maybe the country that I'm competing against in the Olympics that we have a hard past with, that would be hard. But the thing is, Olympians stand together under those five circles. And we stand together under our faith, under the cause that is humanity, under the cause that is love. Remember to love. In our faith Olympics, we don't get medals. We don't get trophies. We don't even usually get recognition. But what we do get is a better understanding of the diversity that God has created and the love that God can share through many different ways. Amen.
As we listen to this next song, I invite you to silently pray. Take a deep breath in, take a deep breath out. Reflect on those places and those people in the world who are hurting, and give thanks for those people and those places in the world that have reason to celebrate today.
I'm Olivia Schlomer, and thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to worship with you today. I will be singing a song that is based off of Revelation 2nd. It's called First Love by Carrie Job, and it talks about the simple, not complicated, and unconditional love that God and Jesus have for us, and that he died on the cross to save us, and he will be our first and our last love. Thank you. I'm returning to the secret place, just an altar and a flame. Love is found here in our sacred space. I hear your voice, I see your face. You're still my first love. You're still my only one. You're still my first love. You're still there's a table just for you and me. Break the bread and pour the wine. Perfect union, nothing in between. I'm yours and you are mine. You're still my first. You're still my only one. You're still my first love. You're still my only you're